you guys doing tonight?
Woo!
Yeah. All right. I'm just gonna start. I'm gonna be honest. I feel a little left out. The word gentrified keeps being thrown around. I have no idea what it means. I'm not even from the city. So, and the dating site thing, I actually just recently have been getting involved in ChristianMingle.com. I don't know who Christian is, but it's pretty cool. I'm getting involved. Although they keep sending me notifications. I'm doing it the best way I know how. And they've been saying stuff like, please leave our site. And if you continue to send messages like this, the authorities will be notified. I think it's a scam gimmick or something like that. But anyway, I'm ZDP. My full name is Zach Dawson-Pitts, and I want you guys to soak that in, Zach Dawson-Pitts, because if things go well and I seem like a nice guy, it'd be really cool if you'd be my friends on Facebook. I kind of want my ex-girlfriend to see me getting a surge of new friends. if you talk to her, it'd be even cooler if you could be like, yeah, I saw Zach. Everyone's pretty worried about me maybe abusing steroids because he's like dangerously in shape now. That'd be cool. So yeah, I'm Zach DP. A little bit about me. Brown hair, brown eyes, about 5'7". My favorite fruit is a kiwi, which I know what you guys are thinking. That's exotic. What's up with them? Like I said, I'm not from New York. I'm from the South. So, you know, things are different. Well, I'm from New Jersey, so things are different there. We eat a lot of fucking kiwi. Some of the things about me, I don't drink. And that's a personal choice. And I feel reluctant saying that at shows sometimes in case any of the girls want to buy me a drink after the show. It'd be really cool if like, you offered a substitution policy and we could just switch it out for a blowjob. we could even do it the amount you would have spent on the drink to how many minutes. I would have gotten a really expensive drink, so we brought your lip gloss. That was a line. I shouldn't have said that. It's, you know what, it's tough getting sex without drinking. Because your hypno is really masked by the taste of alcohol. Which is obviously a joke, because we're hypno is tasteless, so we're just finding sauce for water. I'm a pool boy by trade. That's what I do. I know what you guys are thinking of too. Oh, wow, you know what's up with that? It's not what you think. I get that all the time. Girls like, you're a pool boy? You clean pools with like a mesh tank top? No, this isn't Magic Mike. It's a dirty job. It is. And I had expectations when I first started doing it. I sort of thought every day was going to be like a softcore porn movie. And it turned out not to be that at all. I don't know. New York is weird for me. I spend no time up here. Me and my buddy Sean, he came with me. We were on our way up on the train. And we actually witnessed a robbery happen. Literally, this just happened. We're on New Jersey Transit. And some girl comes up and she's like, someone just took something from my purse. Can I leave my purse here and you guys will watch it? And I'm going to disclose something about me. I'm a 7-time felon. So, like, she really should be. And I was like, yeah, sure, I'll watch your purse, bitch. That's a true story, but I'm reformed, so, you know, I watched her purse. And she went to go, you know, see who took it. And she brings back this African-American gentleman in a seersucker suit. And, you know, she's yelling at him, you took my wallet, you took my wallet. And I don't know, we do things differently in Jersey. I was going to intervene. I was like, look, you know, this is racial profiling. This isn't right, you know. And long, you know, he's like, ma'am, he had an African accent. He said, ma'am, I didn't take your wallet. And I started feeling bad. I was like, this is fucked up. You know what I mean? What's going on here? And she ends up, he turns around and she pulls the wallet out of his pocket right there. And I felt dumb, even though I just didn't think of the scenario in my head. And he pushed her to the ground and ran down the train. And the conductor came and said, don't open the doors, don't open the doors. This kind of stuff does not happen in New Jersey. I don't know. I moved to the beach recently. I'm from the west coast of Jersey. I moved to the beach. And the whole thing out there is different from up here. Everyone's a beach boy. Everyone wants to be a beach boy. Everyone's a swimmer. I'm not particularly a good swimmer. But the first thing I wanted to do when I got there was prove that I'm a beach boy. I want to fit in with the people around me. So right away, I went out to... went out with my buddy Thomas, and I wanted to go out as far out as possible. I wanted to see, you know, what I'm capable of. And almost right away, I got caught in the undertow. True story. And I started drowning. And Tom swam right back to shore. When he was later questioned, he said, I want to assess the situation from the sand, which was because he's like a professional swimmer. He's a lifeguard. And lo and behold, these two beautiful lifeguards, these two, like, 15-year-old boys came swimming out of nowhere. And, corralled me and brought me back to shore. And it was really cool. There were cool kids. I felt awesome. Everyone on the beach stopped and watched, and I felt awesome walking up on the sand. And I felt great with these two hunks on either side of me, and I reached him for a pound, and he gave me a pound, and it was it was a good time. That's my experience being a Beach Boy. That's all I had for you guys. My name is ZDP.